Today we'll discuss the refraction process in terms of real depth, apparent depth and normal shift. This is very well observed in daily life. If any object is immersed in the liquid, like in this beaker, this is the liquid column, water, this is the object, I immerse this object, then what happens? This object appears to be little raised. That height from the free surface is called apparent depth, and the real depth is the total height of the liquid column, and the difference of real depth and apparent depth is called normal shift. It means this object is little bit raised through the refraction process. For mathematical expression, we will use this ray diagram. This is the beaker containing water. This is the object. How we locate the image of this object? Light coming from object, let incident at point O. Light travel from denser to rarer medium, so angle of refraction will be more than angle of incidence. So this is the refracted ray. Another light ray coming from the object, let it is will incident at point A normally, so without any deviation it will be refracted normally. So you find these two refracted ray cannot intersect each other. So how we locate the image of this object? We will extend the refracted ray in the backward direction. Let the intersection point is I. So AI is the apparent depth, AO is the real depth, and the difference of real depth and apparent depth is called normal shift. That is, the object is normally shifted upward through this distance x. To get a mathematical expression, we will use the Snell's law of refraction. So light travels from water to air, so W mu A is equal to sin I upon sin R, equation number 1. The value of sin I and sin R we will find out from the diagram. So in the diagram, in right angle triangle BAO, sin I is equal to AB upon BO. Sin I is equal to AB upon BO. Similarly, in right angle triangle BAI, sin R is equal to AB upon BI, AB upon BI. But the aperture of observer I is very, very small. It means point B is very close to point A, and angle R and angle I are also very, very small. So we can replace BI by AI and BO by AO. So we can write BO is equal to AO and BI is equal to AI due to the small aperture of I. So sin I is equal to AB upon AO. Sin R is equal to AB upon AI. Now we will put the value of sin I and sin R in equation number 1. And if you simplify, then you find W mu A is equal to AB upon AO and AI upon AB. AB, AB cancel out. So W mu A is simply we have AI upon AO, or AI is the apparent depth small h, or AO is equal to real depth capital H. This is equation number 2. And according to the principle of reversibility, we know A mu W is equal to 1 by W mu A. So if you put the value of W mu A using equation 2, we have 1 by small h by capital H. And if you simplify, this is capital H by small h, equation number 3. Indirectly, you can say that the refractive index of medium is simply the ratio of real height and apparent height of the object. That is the ratio of real depth and apparent depth. And how we'll find out the expression for normal shift? Already we know normal shift x is equal to capital H minus small h. So from the diagram, we have normal shift x is equal to capital H minus small h. If you take capital H common, then in bracket we have 1 minus small h by capital H. And the value of small h by capital H using equation 4 is 1 by mu. So if you put the value of h by capital H, then we have x is equal to capital H वन माइनस वन बाई म्यू, इक्वेशन नंबर फाइव. तो इक्वेशन नंबर फाइव एंड इक्वेशन फोर इज़ वेरी वेरी यूजफुल टू फाइंड द रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स ऑफ द मटीरियल एंड द नॉर्मल शिफ्ट प्रोवाइडेड द हाइट ऑफ लिक्विड कॉलम एंड रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स इज नोन. सो दीज टू इक्वेशन वी हैव टू यूज़ फॉर रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स एंड नॉर्मल शिफ्ट.